So, congratulations on a great race today. Can you tell us, how was your feelings before the race? Did you think you were going to win?
Of course, we wanted to win very, very much, and we planned this relay very carefully about the legs, and we had a tactic, and I think that all was very, very good today.
You say that you planned the legs in terms of the tactic. Can you explain how did you decide who would ski each leg?
We wanted to have 1 minute or more lead, yes, and for Paulina, good, comfortable leading, yes, and it was okay. Alena, she's not nervous before the first leg, and we knew about it, and she had a good about 30 seconds. We had the second position, and for me, it was a goal to be also on the lead position and maybe more. And after my leg, it was about 1 minute. And for this distance, it's rather comfortable leading.
Would like to congratulate all of you on a fantastic result, really leading the race almost from start to finish. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Okay, we're here at Tänndalen in Sweden, and we have the world champions in the relay here. And Olli Markus Taivonen, and you were doing the first leg. How was your leg today?
It was very good, because after yesterday's long distance, it was my biggest disappointment in my career. So I managed to do top race today.
Okay, so you were really fit for fight today when you were starting.
Yeah, that's true, because relay is always relay, and there is two guys too who want medals with me, so I had to push hard for my friends.
Okay, Matti Keskiranta is doing the second leg. How did you feel when you saw that Olli Markus is coming in a big lead, and then you could kind of have your own race? Did you do it?
Yeah, actually I had my own alone race today. There were no more tracks from the previous leg. I had to be very careful with the crossroads and take the sure route choice and try to keep the speed as much as possible. I knew that the guys behind will be catching me a bit, but just tried to hold on and rely that in the uphill in the forest it will be better, and just that I get the lead in the intermediate control, I will keep it till the end.
So you were not worried about the guys chasing you uphill?
No, not at all. I didn't look back.
Okay. I saw that you were giving some instructions for Staffan Tunis for the last leg. What did you say?
I don't remember, and you shouldn't ask me either.
Okay. Staffan Tunis, I think we can call you if not the king of Sweden, maybe king of Tänndalen. What do you say about that?
Sounds great, I think.
Okay, you had also a very good leg today as a last leg runner. How was your race, actually?
Well, I felt really tired in the beginning here at the flat, in the flat area in the beginning of the course, and Arneson caught me nearly there, and I was actually a bit worried, but when we started climbing uphill, I felt strong, really strong again, and I knew that I have good chances to take the victory.
You were not watching over your shoulder, no?
Well, actually, I was watching over my shoulder, and I saw that he looks really tired. So.
That's good. What were you thinking when you were crossing the bridge the last time and you knew that you're going to take the gold medal?
I don't remember, but really great feeling, of course, to take the gold medal in relay again, as we did 2 years ago also. So it's really, really fantastic feeling, of course.
And guys, how are you going to celebrate? Maybe tonight and maybe 6th of December at the President's Castle, but how about tonight?
Yeah, of course.
You're sleeping, then go working.
I'm going to the Eastern Sweden to run orienteering.
Okay, thank you.